Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Hi.
This is John, Tom, and Chris reporting here from Geeks and Freaks.
All right. Let's get going.
All the way from where are you?
Sunny Birmingham.
Sunny Birmingham.
Birmingham.
Sunny Birmingham.
I knew that. I meant more specifically, but we don't have to give specifics because the internet.
E3, guys.
Are we?
Let's get this started. Here we go. I was pressing some button. Broforce is 4. We use this as a backdrop for our discussions. So yeah.
I've been watching everything, man. So, nice. What's everybody watched?
I missed the first day completely. So I missed Beth. And I've watched half of Microsoft, I've watched EA, I've watched UB, I've watched Nintendo, and I've watched Square Enix.
So the only ones that I haven't watched currently are Nintendo and Square. See you later. Right,
So we've covered all bases, so what should we start at?
Should we start at what started? So should we start at Bethesda?
Sounds good.
Bethesda, yes. That was amazing.
So Bethesda was actually a really, real big surprise for me.
Did you see how big that screen was behind him?
The screen was tremendous in stature.
I can't remember how they said how big it was. It was like the resolution was enormous.
The thing that made me laugh quite a lot about the about the Bethesda one is the fact that they had that massive screen, but it was really quite badly broken. Like it kept like.
Yeah, sorry.
The left side of it kept turning off and stuff.
Flickering.
So Bethesda, obviously a big announcement from them. Well, not the big announcement, because they'd already announced it last week, but the big deal from them was
Fallout
4.
Fallout 4.
Yes.
Fallout 4. Did everybody see everything about Fallout 4, yeah?
I showed John the trailer earlier.
Yeah, it looks amazing.
It does look really, really good. So
I'm excited.
Fallout was one of the kind of games that I wasn't too sure about how they were going to take it into the next kind of thing, because it's always basically been the same kind of thing. I mean, obviously they changed the style when Bethesda picked it up from the isometric to the old first person.
Yeah,
but
Fallout 2 is still one of my favourite games ever, and yeah. Fallout 3 was good, but Fallout 4 looks like
shit.
Thanks for killing me there.
Sorry.
Fallout 4 looks fucking.
Everything that they're doing with it, it seems like they're not just making another kind of title in the Fallout series. It looks like they are literally taking it as far as they can with all the.
The environments look astounding. The cities and all the
colony building stuff and.
Yeah, I didn't even tell you about that. Bases and.
So basically, one of the things that they've introduced in the new Fallout jump is the fact that you can create your own bases. Basically you pick up random bits of stuff from around the environment, so rubber tires, old bits of wall and stuff, and you craft it down to its base materials, so you'll turn like a door into wood, and then you can use that to craft your own doors and walls and stuff like that.
Nice.
Which allows you to basically make your own bases, but you don't just make your own bases, you make all of your own you make trading posts and stuff, and if you make trading posts, traders will come. So you basically make all your own colony, and you have to make defences for it and stuff like that as well.
Nice.
I'm dead again.
God damn it. But obviously, all kind of optional stuff. But it does look pretty cool.
Sounds amazing.
It looks like there's a lot of game there.
Yeah.
And then on top of that, mods. And they've announced that you will be able to play mods on the Xbox One version, which is beautiful.
Yeah.
And that also comes with Fallout 3.
Yeah, it does. It comes with Fallout 3 as well, and we'll get a little bit onto that, what that means, in a little bit. Another thing that I was a bit surprised about was I wasn't all that interested in Doom.
Oh my god, that looks beautiful.
See, Tom told me about Doom, and I was like, oh, Doom, but then I watched the trailer for it with Tom just now, and oh, it looks pretty cool.
I mean, like, I played a lot of Doom, like Doom 1, when I was younger. And yeah, it was good and all that kind of stuff, but it's never been a series that I've followed. It's never been something that I've been excited to do.
The latter Dooms really killed it for me. Like, they were nothing like the originals.
Yeah.
Like, if you wanted to play
Tom,
a Doom
you're
game...
you're a little bit quiet, mate.
Hello.
He's moved away.
If you wanted to play a Doom... Oh, I died! If you wanted to play a Doom game, you'd play Serious Sam.
Yeah.
Serious Sam was what the essence of Doom.
Oh.
Nope.
When Doom became
when Doom became worse.
After, I actually blame Dwayne The Rock Johnson for ruining Doom.
You know what? He's kind of responsible.
His starring role in the film of the same name.
Yeah. Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
But yeah, I mean...
Get out of my Doom.
I'm excited to see what Doom is. I hope it's not basically just what they showed in the trailer.
I'd be happy with that.
It looked good. It looked really well polished and stuff like that. But it did look like very, very 90s first-person shooter kind of stuff where you just run around
running
and kill
gun.
Guys.
That's all, that they've said that's all it is. It's moving fast and shooting demons.
And I worry, is that enough to kind of game nowadays? Yes.
I think so. I think it'll have the retro kind of appeal.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think enough people want that. I mean, I want that.
Oh, bloody hell. So, before we move on to Xbox, there was one other title that Bethesda showed, which was it called Battlecry? Is that the one?
Yeah, that looks terrible.
Which, yeah, so it looks like they're kind of trying to cash in on the whole MOBA scene.
It looks like a clone of Team Fortress crossed with Blizzard's new game,
Overwatch,
yeah, but with melee combat, really awkward, janky, badly animated melee combat. It looks like one of those Chinese free-to-play games. It looks really bad. I just don't get it.
So that, I think that's the only point that it kind of brought down the Bethesda conference.
Yeah, like it was kind of like a shit sandwich, because then they did Elder Scrolls after that, didn't they?
They did. Yeah, which I mean, what do we think about the Elder Scrolls? Has anybody played
the online one? No,
nah.
I've not heard great things, but
yeah, I heard a lot of bad stuff. I've heard a lot of console gamers praising it though.
Now it's free to play, maybe.
Yeah, so we'll give that a bash at some point. Oh, dogs for days. Right.
And then they're doing Hearthstone as well.
They are.
They're doing their own version of...
Which is, what's it called? The Elder Scrolls Legends.
Something like that.
Basically, Hearthstone meets Skyrim.
Really?
Skyrim, Hearthstone.
Yeah, so it seems that although Professor are putting their... They're really putting their all into their new games, into Fallout and stuff like that. It seems that they are very much aware of what's going on with the kind of money-making side of games at the moment, so the MOBAs and the card games and stuff. Stuff that's basically, you know, your free-to-plays, where you can charge people money for certain things, which is where all the money seems to be.
Do you know what else I found weird? That Battlecry. The guy was like, we're currently beta-testing this in Australia and New Zealand.
Yeah.
That's a strange choice. Fair play, give the Aussies some, you know.
Oh, I died.
I'm right.
Oh, everybody died.
Some games to play, but whatever. But Beth, I think they had the best presentation, the best, even though the screen was broken, shit. I think everything about that presentation was great. The video at the start, like going over all the games from last year.
Yeah.
Like Rage and Dishonored. Oh, Dishonored 2 they showed as well.
Oh yeah, Dishonored 2 as well, which I didn't play the first Dishonored.
I've got it on my Steam. I bought it in a Steam sale and still haven't played it, so.
Yeah, I got it when it was free on the Xbox Games for Gold. Still haven't played it.
Right, should we move on?
Yeah, so...
Two thumbs up for Bethesda.
Two thumbs up out of what? Out of what thumbs
out
up?
Of a possible
two.
Three, because I was born with three arms.
Nice. Okay. Where's the third one on your body?
I'll show you later.
Okay, no, right. Well, I don't know if I want to be part
so
of that.
So two out of three thumbs for...
Two out of three thumbs.
Two out of three thumbs for the Bethesda conference. So moving on.
It's moving swiftly onwards.
We had Microsoft.
Didn't see a lot of Microsoft. I've brushed up.
So Microsoft... was that their conference was a lot better than any that they've done in the past few years.
It was
in the first 10 minutes they nailed quite a lot of key things. The big thing to take from the Microsoft conference was the backwards compatibility issue.
Yeah.
So that's something that's kind of been at the core of a lot of people's thoughts since the Xbox 360 came out, was that there was no backwards compatibility for old Xbox games and stuff like that. And obviously they never patched that in the Xbox 360, but they've now announced that they're doing essentially a kind of answer to PlayStation Now, but they're doing it with their old Xbox 360 games. So the idea is that they'll have titles available on the marketplace, but when you put in your old Xbox 360 games, it'll allow you to download them free of charge. So whereas it's not exactly full backwards compatibility. It is still technically a games on demand streaming service.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I just want the other devs to come out with their lists, because the current...
The list isn't very good at the moment, is it, to be fair?
It's not, but...
They've said there'll be 100 games at launch.
Yes, they said there'll be 100 games at launch, and their idea is, well, obviously you have to take everything with a pinch of salt. Their idea is that they're hoping to get the entire back catalogue of Xbox 360 games available at some point. But it's highly unlikely, but obviously, hopefully, if they get the majority of them, that will be a good thing. The question that does pose, though, is how does that work for definitive editions? So, since the 8th generation of consoles came out, so since the PlayStation 4, the Xbox One, there's been a kind of a lot of definitive editions of games, trilogies, stuff like that. So the Nathan Drake trilogy is coming out. You've had the all the HD collections and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
So if now you can play any of your old 360 games free of charge on that same console, where does that leave developers who are looking to make definitive editions? Does it mean that we don't need definitive editions anymore?
Aren't those definitive editions like HD remasters though?
Yeah, they are, but...
And these backwards compatible games are just Xbox 360,
They're just the Xbox 360 games, but I mean, do you think that people will still want definitive editions of games?
Oh yeah, I reckon they'll upgrade the graphics, they'll add new things to make it worthwhile.
Where do you guys stand on definitive editions of games? Do you like them, or...
I love them, if I'm honest. Anything that brings back a retro kind of game that I used to love, and they've just kind of tweaked it a little bit in graphics, love it.
But obviously at the moment they're not really doing retro games, they're doing
last games
that are no more than 3-4 years old.
Yeah, I suppose
so. The Last of Us had a game, and then as soon as the PlayStation 4 came out, basically they announced that Last of Us Remastered would be available.
Mm-hmm.
To me, I don't know, that seems like a waste of time.
That was way too soon, I think.
Yeah,
but I mean, does it mean that we'll have even less of those now that we can play?
I don't think it does, because if a dev's going to release a version like that, they won't make it backwards compatible. Or
that's
will,
true. They just won't sign off on it. Yeah. Didn't they say that the developer has to sign off on the fact that?
Yeah,
that
so the developer does have to sign up for it. So that's the one thing. It's not going to be Microsoft who gets to choose. But yeah, so I mean, the two titles that they announced that would be released with the new ones was Fallout. Fallout 3 would come with Fallout 4 free of charge. And Rainbow Six Vegas 1 and 2 would come with Rainbow Six Siege. So do you think we're going to see more of that in the future? So for example, like the new Gears of War or something, or the new Metal Gear. Do you think we're going to be seeing more stuff like that, where the newer titles are going to come with the original titles included?
I hope so, because it gives people a chance who haven't played them before. Because you run the risk of people who are playing the new Metal Gears who haven't played the actual first one. Not the first one, but like the third, I suppose, Metal Gear Solid. So imagine if that came with it, that'd be brilliant for people to look back from where it's come from to where it is now. I'd like that.
Would do. So if we go through a few of the games, obviously Microsoft went through, because there was a few game announcements, a few game trailers and stuff like that. So the first one, the big one, was Halo 5. So where does everybody stand on the Halo series?
Doesn't bother me.
I'm not big on it at all.
This might not be really the right conversation to have. Because I don't think any of us are really too fussed about Halo.
Nah.
Has anybody played any of the Halos?
Yeah, we used to play them religiously, didn't we, a while ago, but then just kind of died a death. It doesn't change, in my opinion.
Yeah, Halo 4 was so samey, I just didn't like it.
So in the same kind of vein as the question of do we need definitive editions and stuff, do you think we need another Halo?
They've signed up for 6, so they're going to get them, but I don't
think
we need them.
Yeah, that's fine that they'll get them contractually. Ah, oh, bollocks. Do you think that we need them? Do you think that we need another Halo? Speaking story-wise, speaking gameplay-wise, is there much more that they can do with Halo?
If they bring in some new things, instead of it being Covenant and stuff.
My pad's freaking out and I'm running to the right and firing constantly, so
Alright, okay.
Yeah, so if they like bringing new enemies and stuff instead of Flood and Covenant and stuff, which I'm sure they are, it's probably that I'm just not up to speed with it, then yeah, probably. But if they're sticking with the same story, just revamping it slightly, then I don't think so.
They need to innovate it, really, I think. Yeah. Like, when I was talking to you, Chris, when that... I'll probably talk about it later, but we were watching a stream together and the game came on and I was like, I'm so bored of games like this.
Yeah.
Like, is that me?
Yeah,
that's your blade at the bottom. I don't know what's going on. You want it to sort your controller.
No, my pad's going weird. Yeah, they need to do something to make it different because I'm tired of Halo now. I'm tired of Master Chief. I'm tired of the multiplayer. I'm tired of the same maps.
Mm.
Just feels like the same game. My pad is having a real, real episode here.
Yeah, like, no matter what you do with the multiplayer, it does feel exactly the same, like you're saying, Tom. Like, yeah. They can make as many new maps as they want to. It's the same basic layout. It doesn't feel new to me. You might as well just be playing Reach or 3 or something online.
Okay.
Now, speaking of which, we forgot something about Doom. Did you see the map maker?
Yeah, jumping back and we'll quickly come back to Microsoft in a second. Mapmakers. Anybody used to use the old mapmakers on the old PC games?
Quake.
And stuff?
I used to make a lot of Quake maps back in the day. Yeah. But that was very difficult. You had to render it, there was a lot of messing around. But this Doom thing, it just looks like you can make a map in seconds.
Yeah. And I think that's the important thing is that, especially for consoles,
yeah, it's
the map maker things and stuff like that has often gone kind of untouched because obviously with console controls and with the kind of finicky kind of thing with map makers, not many people are using them on consoles. So by doing it as easily as it appears to be on Doom, do you think that's something that you'll use? Are you those
definitely
kind of people
I remember getting, I think it was Halo 3, and they said there was a map maker. But it wasn't really a map maker. You could just put down guns on existing maps, and I was so disappointed.
Yeah.
But this, you put down blocks. Like, they're predetermined blocks, so there's a set number of rooms and stuff. Like, shapes of room, things like that. But that's all you need, really. It's just building blocks. It's just Minecraft. Mm. With big blocks dropping down.
I think the interesting thing with this, though, is that you obviously get to choose not only the shape of the maps and stuff like that, but you also get to kind of predetermine the rules.
Yeah, you can change the logic and set like multiplayer rules, things like that. It does look really cool.
So, I mean, that hopefully with something like that, it will keep it pretty fresh. With that in mind, they mentioned that they were looking. Well, one of the fan-made maps that they talked about was one where it was an endless wave of enemies and then you used points that you got from killing enemies to buy additional weapons, much in the kind
so
of...
So it's like Counter-Strike, yeah.
Counter-Strike and Call of Duty Zombies and stuff like that. So do you think that poses a risk to games like that?
You're gonna have to have a map maker from now on, otherwise no one's gonna want it.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, that's just unlimited map DLC right there.
Yeah, exactly. So for games like Call of Duty where they charge £10 a month, £10 for each map pack for an additional 3 maps or something.
Yeah, whereas...
And then you've got stuff like Doom, which is just basically giving away maps absolutely free.
Yeah.
And maps of all shapes and sizes. Sorry, dude.
You have to go on the left side, mate.
Oh, it's me. Shit.
Yeah, I think it's a big move by Bethesda, and I can't wait, honestly. I think it's going to be great.
So, yes, so hopefully we'll see more of that at Gamescom, which is August, isn't it?
I think so.
Hopefully we'll see more of that kind of stuff there. Going back to Microsoft, then.
Yeah.
We said that we were kind of a bit fed up with the same old stuff that we've gotten from Halo. Did anybody see anything about Recall, which is the new IP that's being worked on?
Yes, and that's made by...
It's made by the guy that worked on Mega Man.
Kaiji Inafune from Mega Man and Armature Studios, who did Metroid Prime.
Yeah.
So that's... I've
so
sold
quick,
on
quickly
that.
Jump into those.
Developers alone.
You into your Mega Man and you're into your Metroid Primes?
Yes, very.
Yeah?
The name alone sells that to me.
Yeah. I mean, what did you think of the trailer? The trailer didn't really show much, so for anybody who didn't see, basically the trailer was a young girl walking through the desert with basically a dog from Half-Life. And they go in, they have a fight with some robots, and then she swaps over her robot's heart with a bigger machine, and then it's basically the same robot just in a bigger shell. That's all they really showed of it. They didn't show what kind of game it was going to be, whether it was going to be like a kind of platform adventurer, or whether it was going to be a straight up kind of Dynasty Warriors fighter. They didn't really explain much of that. But I mean, just from the trailer, Tom, excited?
Yes, it looks great.
Yeah. I mean, but
they could, they might, for all I care, they didn't even have to show a trailer. I would have been like so hyped for that.
So you're more excited about the names that are behind it rather than the actual what the game might be itself.
Yeah, I've got fingers crossed. I'm not.
So going from games that looked pretty good. Oh, bloody hell. Pay attention. Going from games that looked pretty good to games that, in my opinion, looked absolutely gank. Plants vs Zombies: Garden Warfare 2.
Yeah, I turned the stream on at this point and immediately wanted to turn it off.
Yeah.
So, how did that game get a sequel?
So apparently the first one was to solve one. So I'm sure you guys both know Garden Warfare. The first one was basically just
Call of Duty
ripoff.
Yeah.
Yep.
With the Plants vs Zombies skin on it. Now, I don't think that Plants vs Zombies, in my opinion, is one of those series that's kind of like the Minions from Despicable Me.
They've added a minion, haven't they, in this new one?
Yeah, so I mean that they're everywhere, just kind of pop culturally, but I don't think that they really need to have another game and stuff like that. And this one, obviously, instead of just ripping off Call of Duty, it's also ripping off Titanfall, so you can call in mechs and stuff and fight in the same way as that.
Yeah.
Anybody excited?
Nope. No.
Good. Moving on.
Next.
Forza 6. Anybody into the Forza games?
No.
I like watching the trailers because the graphics look nice. No, I kind of want to, but I can't justify spending that amount of money on a game that I might not. Why do I keep blowing up there? I like racing games. But
John, I think it's you, mate. I mean, I know what you mean. So the thing is, with the Forza games, I really like the Forza Horizon games. So they're the open world ones.
Mm-hmm.
Standard Forza games are a bit too linear for me.
Isn't it, to Gran Turismo? That's what they're doing it for.
Basically, yeah. And it's just kind of like you're racing around the track. It's not all that exciting, really, is it? There's nothing really there that's new. Nothing too exciting. But obviously, if you're into your racing games,
if you're into that kind of thing, then
if you're into your racing games, the graphics look good.
Yeah, I'd watch somebody play that.
Yeah, that's fair. Yeah. I wouldn't be asked about playing it myself, though.
Yeah.
dead again, all of us.
We're doing tremendously at this.
That's all right.
The thing is, we can blame the fact that we're trying to talk at the same time.
Oh, yeah.
Did I die? No, I'm not. No,
I'm alive! I'm the worst guy. So okay. What was after Forza?
After Forza, we had the trailer for the much anticipated Dark Souls 3.
Yes, it's real.
So,
it happened.
I've only played a little bit of Dark Souls. I know that John has barely played any Dark Souls.
No,
Played Dark Souls and Dark Souls 2.
Nice.
Okay, so Forks is probably the resident Dark Souls out of all of us, apart from obviously Nomadic KG himself, Kyle, who plays him to death every goddamn day. I thought the trailer was well made. I thought the trailer looked good cinematically. I've never understood what Dark Souls is actually meant to be about, and I've never really played too much of them, so I can't get too excited for it. But when Kyle saw the trailer, he went absolutely off. So I think this is a similar kind of thing to Forza, where if you're into it, it's definitely something worth looking out for.
Oh yeah.
From what I know, the Dark Souls games are always really well made.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's From Software. They've made three games, right?
From Software have made tons of games, but the three main games, the four main games that they're known for are Demon's Souls, Dark Souls 1 and 2, and then Bloodborne, which are all follow the same kind of formula.
So if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Yep.
Yeah, they're all critically acclaimed games, so seems to just be more of the same, which, from what I understand, if you're into it, is a good thing.
Yep, and there's an audience for it, so
yes, absolutely. There you go. Right, so after Dark Souls, we had The Division. So The Division's a game that I've been looking forward to since it was announced way back when.
Well, actually, can I just interrupt? You missed the Elite Controller. Is anybody going to buy it?
The Elite Controller, yes. So the Elite Controller, I think it looks amazing.
Yeah, it looks like one of those...
See, I haven't seen it.
Have you looked at any like pro controllers you can buy online? I'm air quoting. Like, you can buy a pro controller online that's been modified. It's like 80 quid or something ridiculous.
And I think this is going to be the kind of answer. The thing that I'm most excited about is the fact that it's fully customizable.
Yeah.
So something that you can map keys on and stuff like that. It's the kind of precision and the kind of customization that you don't typically get on a console.
Yeah, they never really do this. Third party, but may.
Yeah, but the first actual party, the console manufacturer themselves and stuff will typically not allow you to customize stuff like that. Oh well.
Yeah, definitely gonna get.
See, I haven't seen them, but like by the sounds of that, like mapping keys and everything, for sure, I'm 100% getting one, even though I don't need one.
You can map keys. You can. Everybody just died.
Do you not need one because you're already elite?
That's true.
No. Oh, I thought you were making a joke.
No, I've got two controllers. That was the big
one. I've got two controllers as well. I'm just. Yeah.
So I mean, I was gonna buy another controller anyway. So that's definitely, and also it comes with a 3.5mm headphone jack, so you don't need the stereo adapter if you're using Tritons and stuff like that. Yep. So, all in all, seems like a good purchase.
Yes, solid purchase right there.
Right, so before Forx rudely interrupted me with information about the Elite Controller, Division? Everybody excited? Everybody as excited as I am?
You know, I'm excited. I'd never seen it until that trailer, the Dark Souls trailer.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, it was announced a few years ago. I want to say 2 or 3 years ago.
Yeah, this is what I'm thinking.
It was back when Tom Clancy was alive, at least. So.
Yeah.
So, The Division, just to get you updated, folks. So, basically, what happens is a virus is put on money on Black Friday. So, the virus spreads like really, really quickly throughout New York. And then, you and three other people form it's basically kind of post-apocalyptic, kind of Ghost Recon-y, salvaging weapons and modifying them and stuff like that, and using all futuristic tech as you put in Ghost Recon. Looks amazing.
Look astounding. The multiplayer looks beautiful.
Yeah. One of the interesting things is that it's kind of quasi-MMO.
Yeah.
So, rather than just having hundreds of people walking around, what you'll do is you'll bump into other divisions. So other divisions of four people, and you can either choose to work with them, or you can rob them, or you can do both. So the trailer that they showed last night showed a division coming up on the team that were playing, and they worked together to take out some enemies. And then just as they were about to get to, like, on the chopper to get out of there, the guys that we were playing, or the guys that were playing at the E3 conference, turned on them all to death. So it's gonna be an interesting dynamic to see how everybody works, and you can even turn on members of your own team by the looks of it. So that'll definitely be fun to play, especially if you're playing with guys like us who are absolute assholes to each other.
It's one of them games that we're gonna have to get, all of us, because we're gonna have a good little dynamic on there, I think.
Yeah. So speaking of Mr. Clancy himself, the late great. Anybody used to play Rainbow Six when they were younger?
Yeah. But it's been a long time, actually, thinking about it. It's one of them that I want to play again.
So, I mean, now might be the chance, John.
Yes.
Rainbow Six Siege is coming out.
Yep.
5-on-5.
Oh, nice.
Half of you play as the Rainbows themselves. Half of you play as the terrorists in different situations. Tactical choices have to be made. Destructible environments, all that good stuff. To me, it seems like it might be fun to get the old Payday crowd back together and do stuff like that. Forx doesn't seem too interested in it when I was talking to him last night, so why is that, Forx?
It just looked like another generic terrorist shooter. I don't know,
okay.
Maybe... I saw aspects of it that I probably would enjoy, but... We'll see.
For the most part, it's not doing enough move to kind of get your attention.
I didn't think so, but you know what, I'll watch some gameplay.
Well,
over this week, and I'll see what happens.
Cool. John, have you seen anything more of Rainbow Six?
No, if I'm honest, not on that one. I didn't even know that was coming out, but that does sound very, very good. I'm up for getting that.
It's definitely one to watch. Mm-hmm. So we mentioned earlier about how everybody was getting into the MOBA game, and it looks like Microsoft is no different. So one of the things they announced was a game called Gigantic. And the thing is, I say that they're getting into the MOBA game. It's not actually been confirmed what that was. So the trailer just showed a kind of weird owl man fighting like a big snake. So the trailer didn't go into too much information. The trailer didn't go into any information about what the game itself actually is. But just from looking at it, it looks like it might be falling into a gap that Microsoft has yet to fill, which is the
MOBA game.
The console MOBA market, yeah. You guys play a little bit of MOBAs, don't you? So is that something that you'll be interested in, getting a MOBA on the Xbox One?
Maybe. My feelings of MOBAs now has kind of died off a little bit, I think, because we played, you know, League of Legends and stuff like that, but then just kind of like died off a bit. It doesn't sound too appealing. Sounds like a good idea.
I kind of want to get back into MOBAs again. I know we hit League pretty hard.
Yeah.
I'd like to give it another shot, or maybe Smite or something, but yeah, sorry. Sorry, it's a tangent there.
No. Okay.
So yeah, like I'm not sure. Probably if you guys get it, then maybe. But it's not something that's, you know, screaming out at me, if I'm honest.
Yeah. The idea of Xbox games. So.
Was there four?
There was four main ones for the idea of Xbox games. Yeah. So there was Tacoma, which I honestly can't remember what it was. Does anybody remember what Tacoma was?
Nope. Okay. In that case, it doesn't shout out at us, so next.
Next. There was Ashen, which was a survival game where you have to choose who to trust and trade with people or fight people and stuff like that. There was Beyond Eyes, which was a game that was announced a little while back and seems somewhat interesting, but I can imagine that it'll become pretty stale pretty quickly. So, Beyond Eyes, you play as a blind girl. And the world's made up of basically stuff that you can hear and touch. So rather than actually seeing stuff, mate, for example, you'll hear water, and then a waterfall. But as you get closer, you might realise it's a tap. So like the world will dynamically change around you.
Oh, I think I've seen a little bit about this.
That sounds good.
So you don't see, but you see like an audio representation.
Basically, yeah. So imagine Daredevil.
Yeah.
Similar kind of thing.
That's a cool idea.
It's a cool idea. I don't know how long it'll be able to carry the kind of thing.
Yeah, that's the kind of thing that I think maybe after the second or third level, they're going to run out of ideas.
Yeah, so, well, I mean, we'll see. It's definitely one worth watching. Oh, just killed myself. I know. It's definitely one worth watching, but we'll have to see. Mm-hmm. The main idea Xbox game that I was really quite excited about was Cuphead. So, did everybody see about Cuphead?
No.
Carry on.
So, Cuphead is what appears to be a platform co-op. It's definitely a platformer. The co-op, I need to double check, but it looks like it. And basically, it's all done in the style of a 1930s cartoon. So imagine your old Popeye cartoons and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. All of the animation is done in that style, even down to the jitteriness and everything. And all the story, kind of old 1930s cartoon story.
It looks absolutely
amazing. So that's definitely one that we'll have to play. And if it is co-op, that's definitely one that I will get somebody to jump on with me, and we'll definitely do some recording on that.
Mm-hmm.
Ion, did anybody see Ion?
Name sounds familiar, I think I did.
So it was the new game by the guy that made DayZ.
I heard about it.
Yeah, so the trailer showed an astronaut floating through space, and then it cut to a guy, like a fully grown human fetus. But like a man fetus, and not like a baby fetus. Like
a fetus.
A man baby.
A maybe. Yeah.
A maybe meatus.
A maybe meatus.
Okay.
In right. Who knows? It's one of those ones where the trailer didn't show absolutely nothing.
Okay.
Going on stuff that we already know that we don't really know. Rare games. Everybody used to play them.
Yes, that Rare Series, collection.
Battle Zones, stuff like that.
That Rare collection just looks like...
So Rare Replay. It's 30 games for $30. All the old Rare games.
You got Conker, which that is $30. I would buy Conker.
Conker, Project R. All the Banjo-Kazooies and Banjo-Tooies.
Perfect Dark.
Battletoads. Donkey Kongs. All that. Actually, I don't know if Donkey Kong's on there. I imagine Nintendo have Donkey Kong now, don't they?
Yeah. There might be Diddy Kong Racing, maybe.
Potentially.
No, they made a Banjo, right?
Yeah, so all that kind of good stuff, all those 30 games for $30, yeah. That's definitely something to worth look out for if you're into your old Rare games.
Conquering Banjo, for sure.
Then kind of Rare ruined it a little bit, in my opinion, by announcing a new IP that they're working on. Sea of Thieves, which is a pirate adventure, which is a brand new IP. It's like a multiplayer pirate adventure. It didn't look all that. But it might be one of those ones that's in the early stages. So. The
footage of that looked very early, so. But I mean, pirate online. I like those words.
Yeah, pirate like online. Together. Yeah, I'm down for it. If they kind of. They make it a bit more exciting than what the trailer showed off. Anyway, speaking of pointless games, although we weren't. Fable Legends.
Yeah.
No.
What I genuinely have no clue why Fable Legends is still a thing. They should. I really do think. In that case, they should have just cut their losses.
It seems like that's been announced and like going on for ages.
Yeah, and unless I'm mistaken, I'm pretty sure it's been announced as free-to-play now.
Really?
I think so, yeah. So I think it might be a free download or something.
Right.
If that's not true, yeah. But yeah, so Fable Legends, it's really not striking me as anything. It would have been nice if maybe they announced a full Fable title, a full main series Fable title.
I'd look forward to that if they announced one.
Even though they are a little bit, they're not the greatest games in the world. Let's be honest. I still do enjoy playing the Fable games.
Yeah.
But Fable Legends is definitely something that I've got no interest in playing at all.
No, agree.
Yeah. So let's move on.
Next.
Gears. What's everybody think about Gears?
Gears. Yes.
Yes. We're all in agreement that Gears.
The
Gears
remastered Gears 1 and Gears 4, both of them, yep.
Chris, yes.
Come at me.
Chris, did you coin Gears of 4?
Gears of 4
yes.
is a working title.
Nice.
You heard it here first. or either that, or it's going to be called Gears of War, but the A in Gears is going to be the number 4.
Nice. G4s.
G4s of War.
Like Tekken 3, Tack 3 N.
G4s of Wars.
And Fan 4, Stick 4.
Oh, yes. Hold on. There's going to be 4 in the A of Gears and also in War. So it's going to be Gears of War 4.
Nice.
There we go.
Yep.
Slips off the tongue easy.
You heard it here first. So go into your local game shop and put down a pre-order for Gears of War 4.
Hey, Chris.
So, go on. Oh, sorry. It's me. I wondered why anything was happening. Right,
yes,
so.
Chris. Go. We've been doing this level for like 20 minutes now.
Yeah.
Win it. Just steam through it. Go.
Hey, it's shut up. Alright,
No! Fuck!
Okay,
next.
So, Gears of War. The thing that actually really surprised me about that is I've been staying away from Gears news because it's a series that I do like, so if it's a series that I like, I try to tend to not allow any leaks or anything to meet my ears. But what really surprised me about it is when they showed it last night. It's only Gears 1.
Mm-hmm.
So from all the kind of definitive editions and remasters and all that kind of stuff that we've seen over the past few months, it's always been the kind of main series. So you've had the Master Chief Collection, which was Halo 1, 2, 3, and 4, was it?
And ODST, I think, wasn't it?
No, I think ODST was added later, I think. But it's surprising to me that they're only doing Gears of War 1.
Yeah,
admittedly, it has got additional stuff that wasn't on the original Gears, but what do we all think about that?
Testing the waters, I think they are.
Yeah?
Yeah, they'll do other ones if it's successful. If not, then it wasn't a waste of time for them.
Yeah,
I
but
think that's it.
Is it worth the money for just
that's
one
the
Gears
thing.
War?
So there's a thin line between kind of remastering it because people want it and just getting the money back a second time. So Master Chief Collection, it was, what, 40 quid? And you got four games, basically.
Yeah.
So it's a tenner a game. Yeah, they were old games, but they've been remastered and stuff like that. So it's all fair and love and war. Charging full retail price for a game that's already come out.
Yeah.
And then doing the same for the two sequels.
A bit
unbranded. Is that pushing it a bit too much? What do you think?
I think it is. Unless they really... Is it a remaster or is it
a remake?
It's, It's a full remaster, I think. So, the graphics do look improved, so I think they have completely kind of...
But they did that with the Halo Master Chief Collection as well.
Yeah, so in the same vein, so it's they've not remade it, they're not changing anything. But they're just kind of adjusting stuff and redoing them completely.
See, I wouldn't have paid full price for Metal Gear. I would have paid full price for Metal Gear Sons of Liberty remake. So for people who really like Gears of War, maybe. Not for me though.
No?
Nah.
Okay. Speaking of which, where do we think stuff like this stands with the backwards compatibility issue that we were talking about earlier?
They just won't release Gears as backwards compatible.
Yeah? But yeah, do you think?
Because that will conflict with their goal, which is to make money from the remake, not the Xbox 360 one.
But then, does that make them look bad?
I think it does, but it'll be a waste of time otherwise. Yeah. Maybe they time the backwards compatible release.
Did you see that fall to the death?
It's beautiful. So maybe by like 6 months, like in 6 months you can get backwards compatible, but if you want to play it now...
They might do that.
If you want to play it now in higher resolution,
that's definitely £40.
So just quickly brushing over so we can get to one of the most important things about the episode thing. Gears 4, everybody saw the trailer.
Yeah.
Anything that anybody was majorly excited about? I mean, for me, I'm a massive Gears fan, but it did look like just more of the same. I'm interested to see what they do with it. But it didn't really strike me as a next gen, like a generation 8 Gears title.
Yeah, I think
title.
It's too soon to get excited about that.
Yeah.
I think.
Wait a minute. Wait and see.
I think Gears is one of those games that they can do the same thing again. Because it's so, like, iconic.
It's a different team, isn't it, now? Like, Cliffy B's left.
Yeah, so it's actually a completely different dev team. So, yeah, so it's the Coalition. Currently making it as opposed to Epic Games who originally did it, because obviously, as you said, Cliffy B decided to completely drop everything and hit the road.
Big Cliff.
So actually, going on to that thing, in a similar vein to how 343 picked up the Halo series from Bungie, do we think that another team can work on a series like Gears? In general, not speaking about the Coalition per se, but in general, do you think when a certain team has worked on a series for so long, do you think it's then...
There's a risk, isn't there?
It's difficult because they can either do the same thing the first company did, and then they can either do that good or bad, or they can do something different, which will either be taken well or negatively. Like, there's so many outcomes of this.
You're open to critics more so than anything else, aren't you, as well? If you make a brand new game, because you're open to scrutiny.
So, I mean, can we think of any times when it's worked, when a game series has been okay, and then it's been taken over by somebody else and become amazing, for example?
Off the top of my head.
No. That says something, actually, doesn't it? No, I can't really think of anything.
No. I mean, the only times I can think that it's obviously it happened with Halo, it's happened with Gears. The only other time I can think that it's happened is with Crash Bandicoot. And after the third one, it kind of went... It definitely went downhill somewhat.
Oh. Well, when Rare were bought out by AMS, didn't a lot of the team quit?
Yeah.
And then they started making awful games.
No!
I think... Maybe, because I know a lot of the Blizzard guys, they left and then they released like Warcraft 3 and stuff, so that's the time it's worked, but I'm not sure how much of the original team was around for that.
Yeah, I mean, I suppose it's one of those, we can kind of say whatever we want, but we're just going to have to wait and see really with that, aren't we?
Suck it and see.
So, as I said, I think the most interesting thing about the entire Microsoft conference was the HoloLens.
Yeah,
that looked
so
astounding.
Impressive. Really,
so,
really impressive.
But how I want to see that. I want to put that on my face and wear it.
Yeah,
I don't want to see a camera because, you know.
I've got a feeling it's going to be crap when you look at it. Although, I hope it's as good as it looked.
So where do we think the stuff like that will apply? Because it's not going to apply to all games.
No.
So stuff like Minecraft is obviously stuff like Minecraft and your city builders and stuff it's obviously going to work perfectly for. If you can see your entire city and move it around and plonk stuff down and stuff like that,
yeah,
it's going to be really good.
But it's more of a god mode, isn't it? It's not actually playing
simulator
the game.
Games like yeah, maybe. Elite Dangerous, that is would be with the HoloLens.
Yeah.
Train simulator, yeah.
Yeah, I was thinking stuff like real-time strategy games.
Nice.
So, obviously, I don't really know any real-time strategy games anymore, but Command and Conquer. You can see your entire battlefield and tell
Halo
people what
Wars.
To do.
Imagine if they bring a Halo Wars 2 with HoloLens.
Yeah, there's lots of stuff. The one thing that surprised me is that they actually... is that they partnered with Oculus Rift when they're doing that.
Yes, Chris! Who's that? Who did it?
It was me!
Get it! Yes!
We did it!
That's been 20 minutes, that has.
We did it!
What do we think about the fact that Microsoft have partnered with Oculus Rift, which is obviously...
Yeah, Kickstarter.
So...
Oculus
thing. Rift is the main virtual reality headset that's on most people's minds at the moment.
It was the originator.
Microsoft have come and essentially said they bring it out a virtual reality headset as well, but it works slightly differently.
Mm-hmm.
So, what do you reckon? Do you reckon that's going to be competition? Do you reckon it's going to be something that you get both of? So how do you reckon that's going to work? Is it going to be you're going to get one or the other? Is it going to be you'll get Oculus Rift for your first-person shooters and stuff, and then HoloLens for real-time strategy games and stuff?
I'm calling both are going to be separate, and then a hybrid will become available at a later date.
So you'll be able to get the Oculus HoloLens?
Yep.
Also, that went tremendously.
HoloLens, Rift, Oculus...
The Riftulous.
Riftulous Oct.
Riftulous Oct.
The Riftulous Oct.
You heard it here first.
Cool.
That has no mention of HoloLens in the name at all. I just realised.
Riftulous Oct is just the name
that's what they'll call it.
Alright, so I mean, that was the end of the Microsoft conference. Is there anything else that people were interested in about the Microsoft conference?
It was a lot of dads doing two hands, palms up at the camera.
Yeah.
That was their deal.
Yeah. Alright, moving on then.
Shall we just cut this here and do the next one as another video?
Yeah, cool.
Maybe.
Because we're running a bit long. So if we end this here.
Alright, let me stop my audio.
No, I meant we do a little outro first, Chris. Oh, he's gone.
Hold on.
He's here.
Is he, Chris?
I'm here, I just don't know how to keep recording.
Teething issues.
Uh-oh. Oh yeah, anyway, yeah, sorry. Yeah,
we'll
So
we'll come back, we'll do Sony.
Yeah, we've still got Sony, EA, and
Nintendo.
Ubisoft.
Oh, we've got Nintendo, and we'll do EA and Ubi.
Yeah, we'll do EA and Ubi when we come back. And
okay,
then we'll have a look at Sony, because there's a lot to talk about with Sony.
Part 2.
Speak to you soon, guys.
Bye-bye.